founder of SMS Solutions, and I'm here today to tell you how we can improve the lives of factory workers in developing countries by creating a direct link between them and the companies here in the US that buy their products. I'm willing to bet that the majority of everyone in this room can identify these four brands up here. We recognize them, we know their products, we know how to use them, we kind of know their worth, but I'd also be willing to bet that the majority of us don't know who makes these products. And the unfortunate truth is that the companies that buy them generally don't either. And this is the image that companies like to believe is happening in these factories abroad. Happy, efficient workers. But that's not the reality. In many cases, most factories are not full of those previously pictured workers. Here we have Xu, who's a female worker for Foxconn in China. Foxconn is a technology manufacturing company based in Taiwan. They make a lot of products for like HP and Apple. And here, Xu hasn't received her last two paychecks. And it's getting kind of down to the wire, and she desperately needs to buy food for her two children. But she's too afraid to go to her supervisor for fear of losing her job. Her case is not unique. There's an estimated 12.3 million people who work under these same conditions, and 6,000 of them will die each day or be injured from work-related incidents due to these terrible conditions. Now, many people blame the corporations and the companies that employ these workers, which in a lot of cases, these companies are not inherently evil. They want to do good, and they want to ensure fair labor rights and conditions for these workers. The problem is that they don't have the right tools. They're not effective. The current auditing processes that they use provide out-of-date and inaccurate information, and they're really susceptible to manipulation. So that's where my company, SMS Solution, comes in. 80% of the world is currently subscribed or using a mobile phone, and that growth is really being seen more in the developing world. And based on this growth in mobile technology, we provide companies with the opportunity to reach out to the people who are actually making the product. Our service enables them to send these factory workers via SMS, text message, information about government aid related to healthcare and education, as well as gain insight into these working conditions regarding overall job satisfaction, compensation, things like that via SMS-based surveys. We then will take all this information, collect it, compile it into an unbiased report that we then send on to the companies that are our customers. In order to, I guess using this information, companies can then make systemic change to remedy these issues, and it keeps them accountable for the livelihood of the workers. So workers benefit from the useful and actionable information that the companies would send out in the SMS surveys about the government aid programs. They also, workers like Xu, would benefit from having a direct link to the companies, that buy their product to express any grievances without fear of retribution from their supervisors. As I mentioned before, these companies, many are not inherently evil. And they want to ensure these fair working conditions. And I've spoken personally to a couple directors of responsible business from Target and Best Buy, and they've also kind of echoed the same thing. They want to increase visibility in their supply chains and empower their workers, but the tools that they have are slow and relatively ineffective. They're also extremely expensive. The Fair Labor Organization, it's an international organization, has estimated that multinational brands based here in the US spend $50 billion annually on these third-party auditing processes. So the companies, our customers, benefit from cheap, direct, and real-time information that helps them identify and solve these ethical issues before they blow up into huge media scandals, which then causes them to incur huge financial losses. And the increased interaction with suppliers can actually improve their productivity, efficiency, and long-term planning. Now, since this is kind of, I'm in my conceptual stages, my biggest question is, will it work? Ideally, a pilot program would be the best way to find out if the these workers actually can use the technology and that they find it beneficial. So what I propose is to partner with a fair trade certified production or manufacturing company. There's one called Global Mamas that creates baby clothes and maternity clothes from fair trade certified cotton, and they work with a lot of manufacturing companies in Ethiopia and India. So, and they have small factories, about 100 to 200 workers. So I would propose piloting this by giving 50% of those workers the use of this technology, and over a year send out, you know, 4 to 5 surveys and send monthly informational text messages with information regarding the government programs. And then based on that, on their participation and the increase of use of these services, the information and insight gained from the workers, determine whether or not this is a feasible solution to the problem. And ultimately, our goal is to provide an ethical, accurate solution to this global supply chain issue to create more responsible buyers and improve the well-being of their factory workers as well. And with that, I'd like to open it up to questions.